In this video, I'm going to give you my personal comparison of ChatGPT and Claude. I'm going to give you my take on the specificities of each platform, their strengths, their weaknesses. We're going to deep dive into some of the functionalities that I think are most valuable on each platform. And by the end of this video, you will have hopefully enough information to choose whether you want to use ChatGPT or go for Claude. Now, before we start, a little disclaimer. This comparison is going to be most relevant for those of you who don't write code or don't need to. I personally don't need to write code, and so I haven't included this in the comparison. If you need to articulate your ideas often, so you're using LLMs to generate ideas, summarize content, create content, then this comparison is relevant. If you're the kind of person who is busy, has a packed schedule, and is looking for productivity gains or ways to save time, this comparison should resonate. And finally, if you're looking to automate your processes with AI, then you are at the right place. Now, before we start this analysis, my name is Alex. I'm one of the co-founders of 9X. We train business professionals to AI and automation. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to this channel. A quick overview of the different dimensions we will see in our comparison. We're going to compare ChatGPT and Claude on five dimensions: models, apps and their features. This is something I particularly care about. I don't want only to use in a chat interface on desktop. I'd like to use my LLM everywhere, and so I care about the app features. The different ways you can personalize ChatGPT and Claude, their respective workspaces, functionalities, and finally their APIs. Let's start by taking a look at model performance. So here you can see some benchmarks that are made across all models that are being released, and Claude 3.5 Sonnet at the moment outperforms all other models on most dimensions. Now, these benchmarks are always a bit difficult to understand and appreciate. What matters is when you are getting responses from ChatGPT and Claude, do you see that the quality of the responses is better? What I can share here is that my personal experience has been that Claude is a much better writer than ChatGPT. And so Claude has become my model of choice when I need to generate content, write content, or get feedback on something I wrote. One very recent example was when I asked ChatGPT and Claude to help me write the announcement that 9X is going to focus on AI training from now on. And so I share the same prompt with both to see which result I would get on each side. The article I got from ChatGPT was directionally okay, but rather uninspiring. On the other hand, what Claude returned in the first prompt really shocked me. The writing was really good. There's a lot of things that I ended up taking from that initial draft it generated that got into the final article. When it comes to quality of writing, anyways, the best way to figure out which one is the most appropriate for you is to test both models with similar or identical prompts, read the results, and see for yourself. ChatGPT, in its latest models, has a good quality of writing, but Claude is best, and so Claude wins in this area. Then you have the context window, which is how many characters, how many tokens you can have in a single prompt, in a single conversation. There as well, Claude outperforms ChatGPT. The context window of the latest models is 200,000 tokens. And for ChatGPT, it stops at 128,000 tokens. Context windows are increasing month over month. So that's not something that should be too limiting. And also 128,000 is more than enough in most cases. That said, Claude still outperforms ChatGPT with that regard. Then comes the last dimension I care most about. Hallucinations. Does the model sometimes make up stuff and we need to correct it or we need to double check? I found that ChatGPT tends to do that more frequently than Claude. Claude is more reliable with that regard. Therefore, on the model side, for me, Claude wins. Claude has the best model. And so for certain tasks, such as writing important content pieces, I will give it to Claude right away and skip ChatGPT. Second dimension are app features. App features are important for me because I'm using LLMs on a daily basis, multiple times a day. And so I need them to be available in multiple places. I'm using them on my computer when I'm at work, on my phone when I'm on the way to work, and anything that can improve the convenience is for me a big plus. So here are the dimensions that I care about. First, having a desktop app. So I'm not referring to the browser app. I'm talking about a desktop application dedicated. So the ChatGPT Mac app on desktop. And it has actually been 3 days since Claude also has its desktop application. One of the reasons I want a desktop application is to be able to have two windows next to each other. So I'm having the browser open where I work, where I have my different applications. And on the right, usually I have a tab open with ChatGPT or Claude. And it's more convenient to have it via the desktop application. So as of a few days ago now, both ChatGPT and Claude are now on par with this regard. Both also offer a mobile app on iOS and Android. So far so good. Whenever I'm on the way, I can still use Claude or ChatGPT on the phone. Now, when it comes to the big differences and where ChatGPT is ahead, first, web browsing. Web browsing is particularly important for me because a lot of the queries I have with ChatGPT require to browse the web in order to get some information. And that is not possible at the moment with Claude. So whenever your query needs recent information, you can use search with ChatGPT and it will return recent data. What if we ask a similar question to Claude that requires accurate recent data? It's going to usually tell you that to the best of its knowledge, this is the answer that it can provide, but that if you want up-to-date information, you should look for it online and verify. And so basically for all of these queries, I don't use Claude, I only use ChatGPT. With Claude, you will have to first Google the results, feed that to Claude and let it interpret it. While with ChatGPT, you can just tell it to browse the web, which is a huge convenience factor. Second huge functionality that ChatGPT offers and Claude doesn't is voice mode. When I'm on my phone, I'm actually always using voice mode. If you go beyond the awkwardness of talking to an LLM like in the movie Her, actually, this is a huge productivity unlock because you're able to have conversations much faster without using your hands to type. You can just freely walk, speak, and at the end, get a full conversation with ChatGPT. For me, this is one of the key features that is missing with Claude and that cannot make me switch entirely to using Claude. So when it comes to the different applications and their functionalities, I would say that ChatGPT is still ahead, especially with web browsing and voice mode, which I personally use all the time. If we move on to personalization, this one's also very important because the more you can bring your context to these LLMs, the better, the more specific their answers will be. So here, one first advantage of ChatGPT over Claude is that it has memory. This was added this year and is a pretty convenient feature. ChatGPT memorizes facts about you as you have more and more conversations with it. And there's a place inside the ChatGPT settings where you can manage this memory. But basically, this avoids having to re-explain every time who you are, what you do, what are your objectives. And this is built in and very convenient. Claude doesn't have this functionality yet and forces you once again, whenever you need to provide this extra layer of context so that you get more relevant responses. So that's a big plus for that. And I hope Anthropic has this type of feature in the near future. Now, if we want to compare the personalization features of both platforms, we actually want to compare on one side custom GPTs from OpenAI and projects from Claude. Custom GPTs are personalized versions of ChatGPT to which you add some instructions and new knowledge. They are relatively straightforward to configure. You add some instructions, maybe a specific purpose. You upload some particular knowledge you want it to base its response off. You have also additional capabilities for more advanced usage. And once you've published it, you have a version of ChatGPT that is configured to answer specific questions to solve particular problems. Claude projects work slightly differently. Just like GPTs, you're going to be able to upload some documents, some knowledge, set some custom instructions, But here the idea is really to help you collaborate on a dedicated project. So for instance, I can have an analysis of the performance of my posts on LinkedIn, upload this data inside a Claude project, and have a first conversation where we analyze the post performance. One of the big advantages is we can have multiple chats. For instance, after the analysis, I want to take action and figure out what are the content pieces I will post in November. And all of this can happen in a single Claude project. Now, when it comes to the differences that I care about, I find that the big upside of projects over GPTs is that you can have multiple conversations over the same project. This is a big advantage because you can collaborate on a given project with multiple people with the same context added to the project. And that's something that you can't really do with GPTs. On the other side, GPTs have actions while projects don't. When you configure your GPTs, besides adding documents and instructions, which is the basic setup that most people do with GPTs, you can also configure actions. So when it comes to personalization, I'd say that for now, it's a draw. The fact that ChatGPT has memory is a big plus, and I think a must-have that Claude will have to cover in the near future. But projects is much more useful than GPTs, in my opinion, if you want to work on context-specific tasks on particular projects. It's much better than GPTs. So that's a draw. Moving on to workspaces. So what do I mean with workspaces? Both Claude and ChatGPT allow you now to collaborate on documents, so generate documents that you can then edit. And so you no longer stay in the chat in order to generate your results. You are now using these platforms to create documents and work directly on these documents. OpenAI released recently Canvas, which is their version of workspaces. And in Claude, we've been having for a while Artifacts, which is a similar functionality. So now let's compare them. So on both platforms, you're going to be able to generate text documents. And with that regard, Canvas and Artifacts are similar. One first difference that I do appreciate in ChatGPT is the possibility to manually edit the result. With Artifacts, the only way I have to change the content of the artifact is to prompt again. And so this manual editor, I like the direction that ChatGPT is heading towards. It allows you to make manual edits, do inline editing via prompts, change the format. They have also a bunch of shortcuts to polish your document, make the text longer or shorten it, etc. And so I like this direction because I'm not sure that once you've generated something, the fastest way is to prompt the edits, or that you can make actually small manual edits yourself and then you're done. Next, both platforms can generate code. I don't use code, and so I'm not going to comment on that. I'm just referring to the beginning of the video. Claude outperforms ChatGPT in writing, but also in writing code. And so for that, I put the two on par, but I'd assume that with Claude Artifacts, you would be able to generate much better code. Next, you have the ability to analyze and chart data. While this is possible in ChatGPT, it's not really landed yet in Canvas. So let's take a look at an example here. I asked first ChatGPT to plot the yearly evolution of the world population, the GDP, and the average life expectancy over the past 20 years worldwide. And so this is the type of result that you get from ChatGPT. It's an image that's generated based on the data that it found, but it's not yet an interactive chart. And basically the only way you have then to change it is to prompt it again to generate another chart. With that regard, Claude is a little bit more advanced. For the same query, it returned an interactive chart where we can see not only the results, but also the code that led to the creation of that chart. I haven't had the time to play with its new analysis tool, but I would expect that for any data analysis task, Claude is a much better platform than ChatGPT is at the moment. Other dimensions you might care about: in Artifacts, you are also able to generate diagrams and also images in SVG format. Personally, I don't use these so much, but I think it's a convenience factor also being able to generate these inside your workspace. And so in our fourth dimension, workspaces, Right now, I think Claude is ahead. I would keep an eye on Canvas, which is taking a different direction. And I think you might, in a few months, try to eat the lunch of, why not, the Google Suite. Maybe their goal here is rather to compete with Gemini inside Google Docs. And I wouldn't be surprised that this manual editor, which right now is fairly limited, gets more powerful over time and becomes maybe your main document editor. Let's see. Last dimension, one of the most important for us at 9x, is going to be the APIs. While I do enjoy chatting with ChatGPT and Claude all day, there are some conversations I don't want to have anymore, especially if I'm asking the same thing over and over. And for those things, we are building automations using no-code platforms like Make, Zapier, Airtable. And when you're building automations, what you care about are the APIs that are available on each platform. So here's the comparison, and what's very interesting is you can see on one side the multimodal vision of ChatGPT. There's already a chat API, so if you want to create conversations, and this is used when you want to create, for instance, a support chatbot. You have the completion API. This is more for single prompt to generate one response, more for content generation, for instance. Then you have the embeddings API. This one is very powerful because it lets you inject context inside API workflows. And that is something that is currently missing with Claude's API. And then you have the other types of input. You have the audio API. You have the image API, where behind the scenes you generate images and more. I think we have also model fine tuning, function calling. So you can see that there's a broad scope of API developed by ChatGPT. While on the other side, with Claude, we are right now left with text. So we have the messages API, which is the equivalent of chat API and completion API, that will let Claude perform actions on your behalf in the browser, on your computer. And so for this one, I haven't tested yet. This is something definitely that I'm very excited about. And maybe we'll make a dedicated video on that later. But for now, if I have to compare today what is possible with ChatGPT and what is possible with Claude, ChatGPT wins largely because of the different modes of interaction it offers. It's not just text. You can do audio, you can do images. And we've seen also the demos early this year. You will be able at some point to do videos. And so for that, ChatGPT is the leading platform in terms of APIs it offers at the moment. So in conclusion, should you go for ChatGPT or should you go for Claude? My recommendation, if you can afford it, is to use both. On one side, ChatGPT offers much more functionalities. And if like me, you care about taking your LLMs wherever you want, if you want to interact with voice, if you're building automations and you need extended APIs, then ChatGPT is the first choice. On the other hand, the fact that Claude has a better model, that it writes better, that is better for data analysis, also means that if you can afford it, you should get a Claude account just for these capabilities so that you are able to delegate the most important tasks or the ones where Claude outperforms ChatGPT to Claude and continue using ChatGPT for everything else. Now, for those of you who don't have the budget for both, I think the trade-off really depends on how you intend to use LLMs. If you have a basic usage and mostly use it via chat, if, unlike me, you don't really care about voice mode, web browsing, but what you really care about is the quality of the responses, the quality of an analysis, its accuracy, then in this case, it might make sense to go for a Claude license instead of ChatGPT. All right, I hope this overview was helpful. Let me know in the comments if you would like me to dive into some of the points that I mentioned in this video. We can have deep dive analysis. And to keep on receiving more videos of this kind, make sure to subscribe to our channel.